Hey.
Forgetting is normal. What's tough for you to remember is tough for everyone.
But don't worry.
We've got this together.
Today's topic is SNRIs. Let's jump right in with a quick practice question. A 40-year-old man presents with chronic pain and depressive symptoms. What's the first-line treatment? The correct answer is SNRIs. But which specific SNRI should you use? SNRIs stand for serotonin norepinephrine reuptake inhibitors. What is the mechanism of action?
Normally, after serotonin and norepinephrine are released from nerve terminals and bind to their receptors, the unused portion is reabsorbed back into the neuron for future use. SNRIs prevent this reuptake, allowing more serotonin and norepinephrine to remain in the synapse, enhancing their effects.
Serotonin is known as the happy hormone, and boosting it helps with anxiety and mood regulation. But why isn't serotonin alone enough? Imagine your brain is like a team of workers trying to keep you happy, focused, and calm. Serotonin is the team leader, ensuring that everything runs smoothly, reducing stress and sadness. Norepinephrine is the energy booster, keeping the team alert, motivated, and ready to handle challenges. SSRIs increase serotonin, which helps calm emotions. But some patients still feel tired, unmotivated, or struggle with focus, and that's where norepinephrine comes in. It provides the extra push to stay engaged and handle stress. Do you know how norepinephrine affects mental and physical health? What is the mechanism behind this? It keeps the brain sharp, preventing brain fog. This happens because norepinephrine activates the prefrontal cortex, improving focus, attention, and motivation. This is especially important in major depressive disorder, where patients struggle with fatigue and lack of motivation. It provides the push needed to take action. Norepinephrine stimulates the reticular activating system, which keeps the brain awake and engaged. Low norepinephrine levels lead to lethargy, procrastination, and difficulty starting tasks. It helps regulate the stress response and emotional stability. Norepinephrine modulates the hypothalamic-pituitary-adrenal axis, preventing excessive stress hormone release. A balanced norepinephrine level controls the fight-or-flight response, reducing excessive worry and panic. It plays a major role in pain regulation. SNRIs are not only used for anxiety but also for chronic pain management. This is because SNRIs enhance the descending pain inhibitory system, which suppresses pain signals from the spinal cord. How do SNRIs help with pain? Pain signals travel to the brain via the dorsal horn of the spinal cord. However, the brainstem, including the midbrain and the medulla, sends inhibitory signals back to the spinal cord to reduce pain perception. This pain-blocking system depends on serotonin, norepinephrine, and endorphins. Among them, norepinephrine is particularly important because it enhances pain signal inhibition at the spinal cord level by activating alpha-2-adrenergic receptors, reducing pain transmission. This is why SNRIs are effective for chronic pain conditions like fibromyalgia and neuropathic pain. Among SNRIs, duloxetine is particularly well known for treating diabetic neuropathy, a useful fact to remember for exams. A simple mnemonic:
duloxetine for diabetic neuropathy.
For pain inhibition, both serotonin and norepinephrine are needed. SSRIs increase serotonin alone, which is not enough to effectively block pain signals. Remembering drugs is tough, but there are two key points. Duloxetine is commonly used for chronic pain, especially diabetic neuropathy. Venlafaxine is often used for generalized anxiety disorder, which is becoming more prevalent in today's high-stress world. Let's review the high-yield points in the last 2 minutes. They inhibit the reuptake of serotonin and norepinephrine. In terms of usage, SSRIs are typically used first, and if their effect is insufficient, SNRIs are considered next. Duloxetine for chronic pain conditions, like fibromyalgia and diabetic neuropathy. Venlafaxine for generalized anxiety disorder. Why do SNRIs cause side effects? Since SNRIs increase norepinephrine, they can stimulate the sympathetic nervous system, leading to side effects like increased heart rate, increased blood pressure. This is particularly important for venlafaxine, which has a dose-dependent norepinephrine effect. One of the most important contraindications for SNRIs is avoid combining SNRIs with MAO inhibitors. Check out this video for more on serotonin syndrome. Venlafaxine should be used cautiously in hypertensive patients.
Why?
SNRIs increase norepinephrine. It can activate alpha-1 adrenergic receptors in blood vessels, causing vasoconstriction and hypertension. They also stimulate beta-1 adrenergic receptors in the heart, leading to increased heart rate and cardiac output. Among SNRIs, venlafaxine requires special caution due to its dose-dependent effects on blood pressure. Today, we covered all the key SNRI points that are commonly tested on exams. I'm cheering for your success. In the next video, we'll cover tricyclic antidepressants, so stay tuned.
For quick, powerful review, this is the only channel. Don't forget to subscribe.